Show. Welcome to the 8 o'clock hour. The Barking Guy is with us. Good morning, Barking Guy.
Morning, Gene. How are you?
I'm doing well. I saw one of our friends at the radio station Saturday, and I said, I need jokes. And so I've been the recipient of some jokes that I have available now to share with Aaron when we get into the 9 o'clock hour. But there's the first one I got, I know it's funny. Let me say it this way, because of who sent it to me, I know it's a joke and I know it's funny. But I'm still trying to determine why it's funny.
Yeah.
So I don't know if I have all the context. Guy comes home to his wife and says, guess what? I found a great job. 10 a.m. start, 2 p.m. finish, no overtime, no weekends, and pay $600 a week. That's great, the wife said. Yeah, I thought so too, he agreed. You start Monday. See, you're wanting to laugh. I'm wanting to laugh, but I'm trying to figure out what I'm laughing at. Why is it funny? What am I not getting about the joke, Barking Guy?
I don't know.
A great job is what the name of the joke is. Guy comes home to his wife. I've found a great job. 10 a.m. to 2 p.m. No overtime, no weekends, pay $600 a week. That's great. I thought so too. You start Monday. So the job wasn't for him? The job was for her.
Yes. Probably. That's the way it sounds to me.
Yeah. Okay, so that's 4 hours a day, right?
Yeah.
It doesn't say if it's... Oh, no weekends right here. And it pays $600 a week? So $600, if it's 4 hours a day times 5 days.
It's 20 hours.
20 hours. So divide it by 20. So that's $30 an hour.
Mm-hmm.
That is a heck of a job.
Yeah.
Okay. So I apologize. He came home and found her a job, $30 an hour? I don't know. Is he trying to get her out of the house from 10 to 2 each day?
I'm not sure.
Because he's got something going on? I don't know. I apologize, folks. Let me say it one more time. Y'all are probably just laughing, right?
Yeah.
They're probably just sitting there laughing, going, how can you be so dense? All right, I'm going to read it again. A guy came home to his wife and said, guess what? I found a great job. A 10 a.m. start, 2 p.m. finish, no overtime, no weekends, and pay $600 a week. That's great, his wife said. Yeah, I thought so too, he agreed. You start Monday. And at first I thought, well, maybe he's talking about working around the house, being a housewife. But a housewife, if they have kids, doesn't start at 10.
No, that's all day.
They're up crack of doom, you know, getting everything ready, getting the kids off to school or wherever it is that they need to go and get the husband off to work, if that's how they have it set up. So it can't be that because, you know, that's an all-day gig. And that's weekends. And that's overtime. So it's not that.
Uh-huh.
Okay, I don't know. Somebody's going to have to explain it to me why it's funny. And you're not seeing why you're not.
I'm not seeing it either.
You're not seeing it either. Okay. But I don't want to discourage this gentleman from sending me jokes, because more often than not, they're funny. But I'm still trying to understand, and so please help me out, folks. And I'm not trying to be disrespectful or anything. People are screaming at the radio right now. It's funny because... So if you have the Facebook thing, go to our Facebook thing and comment on the broadcast that's going on right now. Help me out. All right, Barking Guy is with us. What a successful week for the Bulldogs and the Lady Bulldogs this past week. And the Barking Guy here to tell us all about it.
Yep, we'll start with baseball. Artesia, 18. Lovington, 1.
Wow.
I counted not six, but seven homers.
Seven home runs.
In that game.
Yeah.
Two by Nia Estrada, one each by Josh Madrid, Nathan Taylor, Julian Rodriguez, David Molina, and Ethan Ramirez.
So that would add up to seven.
Yep, and Davian's homer was a grand slam.
Yes, it was.
And Josh Madrid was the winning pitcher. And then we go into the doubleheader, Artesia 15, Lovington 1, opener. Highlight of that game was the inside the park homer by Josh Madrid.
Yep.
Artesia 14, Lovington 4, the nightcap. Bottom of the sixth, bases loaded, one out. Nathan Taylor to the plate, 13-1 Artesia. The first pitch, he fouls off to the cows.
Yeah.
Moo. The next pitch gets by the catcher, and Bradley Valenzuela scores the winning run.
And that was it?
Yep. And then it was Goddard 2, JV 1 opener, Goddard 7, JV 6 nightcap.
You know, that reminds me of another phrase. When that run comes in on the pass ball, wild pitch, a lot of times the phrase is, and that's all she wrote.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe that's the $600 a week job. And she's sitting there writing from 10 a.m. until 2 p.m. Monday through Friday.
Maybe.
And then the winning run comes in, and that's all she wrote. Most sports writers are men, at least, especially if you go back in the day, they were all men. They're not all men now, but, you know, for the longest time, they were. So why would the phrase be, and that's all she wrote? Wouldn't it be, that's all he wrote? So I don't know. I'm asking all these deep questions today. You may continue, Mr. Barking Guy.
Now it's on to softball.
Okay.
Artesia 9, Portales nothing, opener. Artesia 11, Portales 3 in the nightcap. Caden Apodaca and a two-run homer in the nightcap. Also was in the nightcap was that 9-2 double play that wasn't. Originally, the ump called the runner out at the plate. Then he reversed himself with a 1-1 count. 1-1 count to the next batter afterwards.
Yeah.
After lots of discussion.
That's right.
But no matter, one Portales run wasn't going to change the outcome of the game.
That's right.
But that was the first time I saw something like that, and that's the first time you saw something like that.
We've never seen that before. And I'm talking to folks over the weekend, and they we're talking about we want to go back 4 years now and start reversing some calls. If apparently there's no, you know, the precedent has been set that even though the next batter has batted, has seen a pitch, and I think that was another thing that was adding to the confusion is, okay, if we're going to roll back to correct this call, what's the count on the batter? And the ump said 1-1. I was like, well, how can it be 1-1? We've rolled back time to correct a call. So shouldn't we start over again with the batter since we've rolled back time? What if that batter, Barking Guy, had hit the first pitch into an out? What if the batter had hit the first pitch into a base hit? What if the batter had hit a pitch and hit a home run? Do you take that run off the board and roll it back so that you can fix the previous play and then roll forward? Or, you know, there's all kinds of conundrums that could have occurred from that. But as you said, it didn't have, ultimately, it had no impact on the outcome of that game.
Nope. And then we get into the Goddard doubleheader. Mm-hmm. Artesia 13, Goddard 1 in the opener. Riley Crandall is now 9 strikeouts away from 600 in her Bulldog career. Artesia 13, Goddard 2 in the nightcap. Riley Crandall, Caden Apodaca, and KJ Ray each had homers.
Mm-hmm.
And Elizabeth De La Riva drove in the game-winning run.
That she did.
JV won their game, but it was supposed to be a doubleheader, but the nightcap was canceled.
That's right.
And I have I have 12-1, I have 14-1. You know, somebody told me 12-1, somebody told me 14-1. But I know they won.
Yes, yes. I got the same answer you did.
Yep.
It was 12-1, 14-1, 15-1. You know, they won was the answer I got.
And Tuesday, May 10th, last day to register to vote for the primaries. Remember, you must be registered with one of the major parties recognized in New Mexico to vote in the primary.
It's the Republican Party, the Democrat Party, and the Libertarian Party.
That's right.
Those are the three?
Those are the three.
There's not another. I mean, there's other parties that have representation in New Mexico, but they don't have enough to warrant having a primary.
That's right.
Okay.
There's one other that's recognized.
The Green Party.
No, not the Greens.
Not the Green. Okay.
It's something else. And I forgot what it was.
Constitution Party?
Not or? Constitution Party. It's...
Okay.
It's, you know, it's... It's a left. It's a left-leaning party.
Communist party.
Not the communists. It's not the communists.
Or the socialists.
It's not the socialists. It's so-
okay, well, that's fine. I'm not going to keep guessing. We'll move on. It's not important.
No. And remember, Artesia Clean Beautiful is having cleanups. The next one being May 28th.
Okay.
You have large items to take to the transfer station, but no way to get them there. Give Linda a call. 575-513-0143.
Very good.
And that's also the day of the Guns and Hoses.
That's right. That's right. Charity softball between the police and fire.
That's right. That's also an event that you can go to in conjunction with early voting.
It is. You can go early vote that morning.
Yep. And then go to the game.
Go to the game at noon on Saturday. That Saturday.
And this week in old-time radio, radio history. Today, April 25th, Guglielmo Marconi was born in 1874.
Italian?
Yep.
Many people credited with inventing what is now today's modern broadcasting.
That's right.
And his first, the first application of his technology wasn't in an ocean-going ships.
I believe so.
Allowing them to communicate with each other and with the shore?
Yep.
That was a Marconi, I think.
Yep. And Edward R. Murrow was born in 1908.
News reporter extraordinaire.
Yep. WKNR, Keener 13 in Detroit, Michigan, signed off the air in 1972. Today, the letters WKNR is used by a sports radio station in Cleveland, Ohio. There's still a radio station in Detroit on the 1310 frequency that Keener's broadcasted on, but it's now a Spanish station.
Gotcha.
And their call letters is WDTW.
Okay.
And, you know, after the Keener period, that station went through a lot of gyrations and a lot of different formats until they... they decided on being a Spanish broadcasting station.
Yeah, well, hope it works for them.
And April 26th, Lum and Abner premiered in 1931, Gunsmoke in 1952.
Yep, radio shows.
Yep. April 28th, Lionel Barrymore was born in 1878.
Speaking of Gunsmoke on the radio.
Yeah.
Was it James Arness?
No, that was TV.
That was the TV. So who played the sheriff on the radio? You don't
William Conrad.
William Conrad, who later went on to TV to play a detective called Cannon.
Yeah.
Yeah, okay.
And April the 30th, Eve Arden was born in 1909. Queen for a Day premiered in 1945. Arthur Godfrey Time. Also premiered in 1945.
Mm-hmm.
May 1st, Kate Smith was born in 1907. Jack Parr in 1918.
Kate Smith probably most famous for her rendition of the Star Spangled Banner.
And God Bless America.
God Bless America. That's right. That's right.
Mm-hmm. Radio quotes of the week.
All right.
Alcohol is a depressive. Depression is not fun.
That's true. Trying to think who said that. Nancy Hussleman?
Yep, Nancy Hussleman.
All right.
He's not for the babies who have no voice.
Clay and Travis?
No, that was Mark Levin.
Mark Levin, okay.
About Governor Polis of Colorado and his pro-abortion stance.
Yeah, well, they're... yeah, okay. Don't get me started on that.
God has designed creation, and you interact with it every day.
Ken Ham.
No, it wasn't Ken.
Okay.
Jesus Christ Show.
Ah, okay.
You're close. Now we have the calendar.
All right. Here's what's coming up this week, folks.
Monday, April 25th, District Tennis Girls Thursday winners at number one, 4 o'clock. Varsity Golf at Bernalillo Tournament, Santa Ana Golf Club, 9 a.m. Tuesday, 26th, District Tennis Boys Friday winners at number one, 4 o'clock. Zia Field Events, Boys Long Jump Discus, Girls High Jump and Shot Put, 3 p.m. Varsity Softball at Lovington, 4:30 and 6:30 p.m. That's going to be on the radio, and I'm going to listen to it.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah. And we're probably going to be up on the roof.
Mm-hmm. And Wednesday the 27th, Zia Field Events, Boys High Jump and Shot Put, Girls Long Jump and Discus, 3 p.m. Thursday 28th, FFA Banquet.
Hmm.
And the Varsity Baseball versus Goddard, 5 p.m. That's where I'm going to be. Zia Running Events at Bulldog Bowl, 4:30 p.m.
Okay. Still trying to get those qualifying times in.
Yep. Friday 29th, Varsity Baseball at Goddard, 5 and 7 p.m. And then there's the Varsity Track, Larry Baca Invitational, Los Alamos, 3 p.m.
Okay.
Saturday the 30th, District Tennis Individual Tournament at Artesia, 8 a.m. And Sunday, May 1st, Selection Sunday for tennis, Class 2A to 5A baseball and Class 4A to 5A softball.
Okay.
Results out by 10 p.m.
That's on Sunday.
On Sunday.
Okay.
So we'll know where we'll stand.
Yes. I hope people don't get offended by my comparison to selecting a pope. I wonder about that when I say that. You know, the NMAA meets in conclave.
Mm-hmm.
And when we see the white smoke out of the chimney, we know there's a bracket. I hope people find that humorous and not offensive. I'm not trying to offend anybody.
I think it's humorous.
Yeah.
But I don't see any white smoke. All I see is I go to the brackets on Max Preps.
Oh, I know.
And if there's brackets, then I'll start writing and start, you know, compiling stuff for...
Preparing
for
something
this.
Else, too, that there was a comment, and, you know, I'm kind of sensitive to these things because we try to do as good a job as we can, and sometimes we don't do as good a job as we can. We come up a little short. You know, it's been a heck of a time trying to find people, whether it's announcers or camera operators or whatever, not just here, but in Roswell, with Roswell and Goddard. In baseball, you have to remember, we have some of the most spectacular facilities for high school sports anywhere in the state of New Mexico. And probably, I would say we're probably in the top 20% of facilities around the country. I'm sure you're going to find some other facilities that are nicer on a high school level, but not many. Maybe we're in the top 10% of high school sports facilities. Then you got a lot of average sports facilities, and then you've got some challenging sports facilities. And so there's a level that we want to achieve whenever we go to a game, and it's not always possible to do because of, you know, a number of different factors. Again, people available, technology, so forth. So the last couple of games, the baseball series with Lovington. We played, Lovington this past weekend, and then softball with Goddard. I've started inserting some instant replay. Now, are we ESPN instant replay? Do we show 15 different camera angles of the play after the play? No.
No.
No, we have basically the shot, the two camera shot that we do. Yeah. And so I finally got it set up. We were doing a little bit during basketball, and I thought, well, I'm going to throw some instant replay. Kid gets a hit, or a kid makes a great play, whether it's a throw in the infield or a catch in the outfield. But they get a hit. Let's show the play over again while Jovi's describing what's going on. Baseball and softball, you have a little more time, because once the ball is put into play and the play concludes with whatever run score or wherever the base runners wind up, you've got a few seconds there before the next batter steps to the plate and starts seeing pitches. So it's a natural place to insert. Let's look at that play again. Let's look at that base hit. Let's look at that hard throw from third to first. Let's look at that home run. And somebody made a comment that they didn't really care for the instant replay after every play. And I was trying to think, do I do it after every play? I don't think I do it after every play, but I do it after those plays that I think, it was a heck of a play by the shortstop, or that was a heck of a throw by the third baseman, or that was a heck of a catch by the center fielder. Whatever it is, I thought, well, that's a pretty good play. And then if they get a hit, base hit, double, home run, whatever, I would show that again. So, I'm never satisfied. I'm always trying to throw in some different things. But when I think I'm doing good, hey, we've added instant replay. And then I see a comment from somebody that says they don't care for it after every play. So I guess I need to understand what the average viewer would consider to be excessive use of the instant replay or an acceptable use of the instant replay. Or should I not even mess with it? You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
I'm not quite sure where I need to be in that. So I saw that comment, and it kind of knocked me down a notch, because I thought, hey, we've got instant replay now. I have figured it out. Jeffrey's doing a great job on the camera. We're getting some great shots of some of these plays. Kid gets a base hit. Let's show the base hit again while Jovi's describing it. Third baseman makes a great throw from third to first. Let's show that play again while Jovi's, recapping the play for the radio listeners. So, I don't know. Let me know what you think would be an acceptable level. Do you have anything else for us today, Barking Guy?
We got it all in.
We got it all in. All right, let's take the break, see what is going on here. Hopefully, our kith and kin visit will be here shortly.
Remember, go Dogs. Arf!
All right, we'll be right back.
The 2022 district season rolls on for your Artesia Bulldogs and Lady Bulldogs. And coming up on Tuesday, your Lady Dogs travel to Lovington.